Assalamualaikum. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. How are you today? My name is Hana Sari Widya Kusuma from Areta Medika Utama, Biomolecular and Biomedical Research Center. In this presentation, I will present about our study about the pineapple core extract as an anti-inflammatory agent. The title of this study is Anti-inflammatory Activity Screening of Pineapple Ananas Chymalis Core Extract in Lipopolysaccharide-Induced Raw Cell Lines. The introduction. Inflammation is an immune system reaction that can be caused by a number of factors, including damaged cells, pathogens, and toxic substances. The inflammatory cytokines are produced by activated macrophages, which play a protective role for the host in inflammatory conditions and also preserving normal cellular condition. This is the inflammatory cytokines such as interleukins or ILs, the tumor necrosis factor or TNF-alpha, nitric oxide or NO, and prostaglandins or PG. So, the suppression of pro-inflammatory mediators can be an effective indicator of anti-inflammatory drugs. Ananas chymalis, which is known as pineapple, is a species of tropical plant, belongs to the Bromeliaceae family. Ananas chymalis has some bioactive compounds such as bromelain, flavonoid, polyphenol, alkaloid, saponin, saccharin, terpenoid, etc. Ananas chymalis can prevent undesirable inflammatory process and also has anti-inflammatory activity. Based on another study, the pineapple core extract or PCE exhibit as antioxidant potent by DPPH scavenging activity. So this is how the author interesting to research about the anti-inflammatory activity in pineapple core extract. The objective of this study is to evaluate the anti-inflammatory activity of PCE through the inhibitory activity of pro-inflammatory mediators, including PGE2, IL-1 beta, and TNF-alpha on LPS-induced raw cells. The materials and method. In this study, first we extract preparation using maceration technique and using the 70% ethanol. And then we prepare it of raw cell culture. The raw cell culture was obtained from the Biomolecular and Biomedical Research Center Areta Medika Utama. And then we did the viability cells to determine the safe and non-toxic concentration for the next assay. In this method, we using MTS assay. So briefly, we pro-inflammatory activation of raw cells to make the inflammatory cells models. And finally, we quantification of PGE2, TNF-alpha, IL-1 beta levels in raw cells. In this method, we using ELISA method. This is the pineapple core extract preparation. First, ananas chymalis plants were obtained from Tambak Sari Village, Subang, West Java, Indonesia. The plant has been identification at Herbarium Bandung Laboratory School of Biological Science, Bandung Institute of Technology. The preparation of ananas chymalis based on Frianti et al. Method. First, ananas chymalis was sorted and then was weighed in wet way, dried in a food dehydrator, and then crushed into powder form until we did the core crude drug. And then the core crude drug was extracted using maceration technique with a 70% ethanol solvent. Every 24 hours, the filtrate was until the ethanol filtrate turned colorless. Before being used for assay, PCE was stored in minus 20 degrees Celsius. This is the results of our study. First, in viability raw cells, as shown in Table 1, we did the effect of various concentration of PCE towards viability of raw cells. The increased concentration was correlated with increased toxicity. Less than 90% of viability cells. In the Table 1 shows the cytotoxicity of PCE concentration on raw cell lines was decreased in concentration-dependent manner and then in concentration 100 microgram per milliliter was demonstrated the lowest viability of cells by PCE with a value 76%. So, the safe and untoxic of PCE in murine macrophage cells were in concentration 4 and 20 microgram per milliliter. This concentration were used for the treatment in LPS-induced raw cells as inflammation cell models. The second, we did the data, the effect of PCE toward PGE2 level in LPS-induced raw cells. As shown in Figure 1, the PCE in concentration 20 microgram per milliliter has a better ability to suppress PGE2 level with value 507 picogram per milliliter compared to PCE in 4 microgram per milliliter with value 795 picogram per milliliter and also positive control with value 870 picogram per milliliter has a better ability to suppress PGE. The PCE significantly inhibits the production of PGE2 level without affecting the cell viability in LPS-induced raw cells. Third, the effect of PCE towards the NF-alpha level in LPS-induced raw cells. As shown in Figure 2, the treatment with PCE in concentration 20 microgram per milliliter potentially inhibit the NF-alpha production with values 345 picogram per milliliter compared to PCE for in concentration 4 microgram per milliliter with value 474 picogram per milliliter and also positive control with value 581 picogram per milliliter. So this treatment indicates that PCE had anti-inflammatory activity. The effect of PCE towards IL-1 beta level in LPS industrial cells. In Figure T, can be seen the PCE at concentration 20 microgram per milliliter decreased the IL-1 beta level with value 217 picogram per milliliter compared to PCE in concentration 4 microgram per milliliter with value 350 picogram per milliliter and also positive control with value 433 picogram per milliliter. This treatment indicates that PCE had anti-inflammatory activity. The conclusion. In summary, the PCE has the potential as an anti-inflammatory by decreasing PGE2, the NF-alpha and IL-1 beta levels. However, PCE protects against LPS-induced raw cells via inhibiting oxidative stress and inflammation. So that I can explain about the potential of pineapple core extract as an anti-inflammatory agent. For the attention and opportunity that has been entrusted to me, I say thank you and good afternoon.